Videos from Mona Yogashala are not intended to diagnose, cure, treat and prevent any illness. Ms. Mona is a trained yoga therapist. She is not your physician and can't possibly diagnose you through the internet. Expert advice is for educational purpose only and should not be a substitute for the medical advice of your physician or any other healthcare professional. It is best to practice yoga on an empty stomach. Always remember there must be a minimum of 3 to 4 hours between your meal and the practice. This will give your body enough time to digest the food and energize your body, making it ready for activity, right? Okay. Now, let's practice our next balancing pose, Vrikshasana, the tree pose, a beginner's level pose from Hatha Yoga. Let us assume samsthiti. Okay, so let's understand this asana is mainly a balancing posture and its main benefits lie in improving balance, focus, concentration and equilibrium to your mind and enhancing the nervous system. Alright, how many of you have experienced that when you balance, you are forced to focus your mind, isn't it? Yes. So let me tell you, Vrikshasana gets its name from the Sanskrit word Vriksh, which means a tree. As per its name, in this asana, you have to pose like the steady trunk of a tree. As we have discussed in our previous session, once again, I'll repeat its numerous benefits, okay? Well, Vrikshasana improves and aids neuromuscular coordination. It tones the leg muscles while making the ligaments and tendons of the feet stronger. This pose helps to deepen the thorax. Alright. In the last class, somebody asked who should not practice Vrikshasana. Remember? Okay, let me tell you. Anyone can do tree pose. But avoid if you have suffered from some kind of injury or surgery. Okay. Besides, avoid practicing this pose if you suffer from insomnia or migraine. And those who suffer from high blood pressure should avoid this pose. Understood? Okay, so let's see how to perform the pose. Let's get started. Be comfortable. Assume samsthiti. Be aware of your breathing. So, stand tall and straight with arms by the side of your body. Bend your right knee and place the right foot high up on your left thigh. Observe. Make sure the sole of the foot should be placed flat and firmly near the root of the thigh. Fine. Also, make sure that your left leg is straight. Just watch. Find your balance. Take your time. Okay. Now, once you are well balanced, take a deep breath in. Gracefully raise your arms over your head from the side and bring your palms together in Namaskar Mudra. Do it gently, don't be in a hurry, alright? Look straight ahead in front of you at a distant object. Let's understand, a steady gaze helps maintain a steady balance, okay? ensure that your spine is straight. Your entire body should be taut, like a stretched elastic band, okay? Keep taking in long, deep breaths. With each exhalation, relax the body more and more. Just be with the body and the breath with a gentle smile on your face, okay? Try to maintain the pose initially somewhere between 10 to 15 seconds if possible, alright? Now, with the slow exhalation, gently bring down your hands from the sides. Don't rush, slowly. You may gently release the right leg now. Fine. Stand tall and straight as you did at the beginning of the posture, remember? Relax, take a few deep breaths. Rest for 10 to 15 seconds. Got it? Now, we will repeat this pose with the left leg off the ground on the right thigh. Okay, so let us start. Are you ready? Okay, do it gently, step by step. All right, now bend your left knee and place the left foot high up on your right thigh. Done. Now check. The sole of the foot should be placed flat and firmly near the root of the thigh. Also, make sure that the right leg is straight. Observe. Find your balance, okay? Be patient. Once you are well balanced, take a deep breath in. Gracefully raise your arms slowly over your head from the side and assume Namaskar Mudra once again, as already you are knowing. So pay attention. Look straight ahead in front of you at a distant object. Fix your gaze on an object right in front of you, whatever is there. Check again. Focus at your back. Is your spine straight? Okay. Also, your entire body should be straight. Be aware of your breathing. Keep taking in long, deep breaths. Just be with the body and the breath, okay? Now, with slow exhalation, gently bring down your hands from the sides. You may gently release the right leg. Relax. Take a few deep breaths and rest for 10 to 15 seconds in samsthiti. Alright, tell me, are you feeling wonderful? Okay, I'm sure with the regular practice, you are going to master this pose, okay? Okay, now sit comfortably in Sukhasana. So, let's understand a healthy body needs to be accompanied by a sound mind, isn't it? Vrikshasana not only activates metabolism but also helps to stabilize your mind, right? And in today's world, striking that balance is extremely essential.